Good afternoon, everyone. Our topic of today's presentation is database security. What is database security? Database security refers to the collective measures used to protect and secure a database or database management software from illegitimate use and malicious threats and attacks. Database security protects the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of an organization's databases. This CIA triangle constitutes a very important aspect of database security. CIA. First is confidentiality. Confidentiality refers to keeping the data secretive so that only authorized users have an access to it. It is roughly equivalent to privacy. Next is integrity. Integrity involves maintaining the consistency, accuracy, and trustworthiness of data over its entire life cycle. Further, availability. Availability of information refers to ensuring that authorized parties are able to access the information when needed.
Why is database security important? Take a look at the link above. The link is by Norris, which gives us a visual representation of the real-time attacks happening across the world this very second. It clearly demonstrates why we need to secure our databases. Semantic estimates that in 2015, 500 million identities were exposed. With an estimated world population of 7.4 billion, this translates to 7% of the world population was exposed to hackers. Security threats, the most common attacks: SQL injection, buffer overflow vulnerabilities, denial of service attacks, and weak authentication. SQL injection. Attacker inserts malicious code into the database program to exploit the vulnerabilities in the application. SQL injection attacks allow attackers to spoof the identity, tamper with existing data, cause repudiation issues such as voiding transactions or changing balances, allow the complete disclosure of all data on the system, destroy the data, or make it otherwise unavailable and become administrators of the database server. Buffer overflow. This exists when a program attempts to put more data in a buffer than it can hold. By sending in data designed to cause a buffer overflow, it is possible to write into areas known to hold executable code and replace it with the malicious code. Denial of service attack, commonly known as DOS. It is a cyber attack where the attacker makes a machine or resource unavailable to its intended users by flooding the machine with superfluous requests in an attempt to overload the system. Weak authentication. The attacker can steal the identity of a legitimate user, gaining access to confidential data. Authentication may not be sufficient when weak passwords are used or are poorly protected. Methods to secure databases: access control, auditing, authentication, encryption, and backups.
Access control. It is the selective restriction of access to a place or other resource. Access decisions are based on an individual's roles and responsibilities within the organization or user base. For example, a human resource specialist should not have permissions to create network accounts. This should be a role reserved for network administrators. Next, we have is auditing. Auditing involves monitoring a database so as to be aware of the actions of database users. This practice can be seen in companies, government agencies, and non-profit organizations to manage compliance with internal controls. For example, an auditor looks for inconsistencies in financial records. Audit reports help an organization demonstrate accountability to internal and external stakeholders. Next is authentication. Authentication means verifying the identity of someone who wants to access data, resources, or applications. Validating that identity establishes a true relationship for further interactions. Various means of authentication can be passwords, OTPs, ATM pins, biometrics, etc. Encryption. Encryption is the process of encoding a message or information in such a way that only authorized parties can access it. Cryptography is the most common method used to encrypt data. Lastly, we have backups. Database backup is the process of backing up the operational state, architecture, and stored data of database software. It enables the creation of a duplicate instance or copy of a database in case the primary database crashes, is corrupted, or is lost. We have three types of backups: a full backup, an incremental backup, and a differential backup. A full backup is exactly what the name implies. It is a full copy of your entire data set. Because full backups are so time consuming, incremental backups were introduced as a way of decreasing the amount of time that it takes to do a backup. Last is a differential backup. A differential backup is similar to an incremental backup in that it starts with a full backup and subsequent backups only contain data that has changed. The difference is that while an incremental backup only includes the data that has changed since the previous backup, a differential backup contains all of the data that has changed since the last full backup.